The new HDB Prime Location Housing Scheme, how is it going to affect you? Hi, this is Billy from AB Property. Welcome to another episode of AB Property's The Real Facts. Over the last few years, there have been ongoing debates on the problem of allocating lands in prime areas for public HDB housing. While the objective is to promote greater inclusion between income groups in the central prime areas and also to promote diversity in the region, it also brings about a lucky draw effect among the Singaporeans looking to buy a HDB. Take for example the case of Pinnacle at Duxton. It is apparent that people who successfully got balloted to buy these built-to-order flats have enjoyed excessive profits when selling their houses in prime areas like Tanjong Pagar. And given the HDB's balloting system, many citizens have found this system unfair to BTO buyers in other parts of Singapore. So, with the purpose of balancing out such inequality and at the same time maintaining the initial objectives of having public housing on prime land, the Ministry of National Development has since announced a series of measures on prime location housing, in short, the PLH scheme. The first BTO project that will be affected by the new PLH scheme this year would be the upcoming BTO launch in the Rochor Estate. Given the various measures introduced, you might be wondering how the PLH scheme can affect you and your future BTO purchases. And today at AB Property, we will uncover the measures of the PLH and how they will likely affect the future of HDB purchases in prime areas. Firstly, the 10-year minimum occupation period, in short, the MOP. It is the required minimum period of stay in HDB BTO flats. The standard MOP of 5 years was implemented to prevent buyers from flipping houses and reselling them within a short time frame after receiving their subsidized BTO flat. Because without this regulation, it will promote short-term speculation that would defeat the purpose of promoting affordable home ownership. Now, with the introduction of a 10-year MOP, this brings about a much longer waiting time from successful bidding the BTO until being able to allow to resell the flat in the open market. It means if we take reference on a 5-year MOP timeframe, if you got balloted to buy a HDB flat at the age of 30, factoring in the estimated 4 to 5 years of waiting time in construction plus the 5-year minimum occupation period, by the time you can sell will be the age of 40. However, under the PLH scheme, you will likely be able to sell your house at the age of 45. So, if you have plans for upgrading your property along the way due to family expansion, you might really want to think twice about getting a unit under the PLH scheme. If you'd like to bunk in with your extended family and rent out the BTO flat to hopefully collect a rental income after MOP, well, I'm sorry to say, renting out is not possible under the PLH scheme. Secondly, the good news is there will be more subsidies for BTO flats that is classified under the PLH scheme, but also it will come with clawbacks. The properties in the central areas are known to command a higher market value, so the PLH scheme will provide additional subsidies on top of existing subsidies to home buyers to ensure that these flats stay affordable to the masses. However, the PLH scheme will also mean that future homeowners are required to pay back a certain percentage of the flat's eventual resale price to HDB when it comes to selling the flat in future. This measure hopes to address one of the main issues highlighted, which is the lucky draw effect. Simply to say, the huge gains from securing a HDB BTO in prime areas has magnified the random effect of balloting. So, with the idea of a subsidy clawback in place, it would then be more fair, as those owning a HDB at prime locations do not get to earn excessive profits upon the reselling of the house. It would also be more balanced to BTO buyers in other parts of Singapore. One likely issue that we will foresee is that future sellers under the PLH scheme may factor in the clawback amount in their selling price to hopefully recover their losses. That may result to an even higher resale price for houses in the PLH scheme, and that might be counterintuitive to the MND's effort. Well, this is something that we cannot tell at this moment because there are also other property measures currently in place, and it's up to the market forces of supply and demand to dictate the prices in future. Point number three, stricter criteria to buy resale flats under the PLH scheme. A typical resale flat allows a minimum of one applicant, and that can be a Singapore citizen or permanent resident. However, under the PLH scheme, there will be an expected smaller number of eligible resale buyers in future because at least one of the buyer must be a Singapore citizen. And also, there is an income ceiling of 14,000 per month imposed on resale flats in such scheme. This is definitely a big difference because the current resale market has got no limitation on the buyer's income. Singles are also not allowed to buy resale flats classified as prime location. Now, the purpose of such a measure is to reduce the potential windfall gains on the PLH homeowners. As you have seen in the news, there have been more and more HDB flats transacting over $1 million in recent years, especially those in the central area. Hopefully, with the measure in place, it will reduce the pool of resale buyers, and this will help to ensure affordability and allow equal access to prime housing. Lastly, lower quota for priority scheme. The requirements to buy a BTO flat classified under the PLH scheme is similar to buying BTO in any other areas. However, there will be lower quotas for priority allocation under the Married Child Priority Scheme. This scheme is for those who wish to live with or near their parents and children. The purpose of lowering the quota is to help to mitigate the lucky draw effect, as those with families living in prime areas will have less advantage in the balloting system. Now, with the introduction of the PLH scheme, you may wonder what is going to happen to the property prices in the future, and are there any other opportunities to be unfolded? One likely effect that we can foresee could be an increase in prices of HDB flats that is just outside the region of prime areas. This could mean that HDB on one side of the road could be labelled as prime location and restricted by the scheme, while HDB flats on the other side of the road are not. As such, there may be an increase of buyers looking to buy into public housing located in prime locations or near the prime locations and are not restricted by the PLH scheme. So, moving forward, with the lower demand due to tightened buyers' eligibility to buy under the scheme, plus the 10 years waiting period, if you are owner of a BTO under the PLH scheme, then you should be mentally prepared for a longer waiting time when it comes to future selling of your flat. And also, you should take in more considerations when buying a BTO under the PLH scheme and ensure that the buying of such houses fits your future plans, such as family expansion. No matter how the future is going to be like, if you'd like to discuss more about your current property selling or purchases, please feel free to contact us at 8444-9706. That's all for our sharing today. Do give us a like or share this video to your friends if you think that it's useful to you. You can also comment below if you have any questions, and we will definitely be glad to help you along. All right, signing off, this is Billy from AB Property. Thank you for watching The Real Facts. See you soon.